smells so good, Tooks. Daddy's big fishing trip was cut short, but I reckon all this vakalolo we made will cheer him up. Not yet, Tooks. Why don't you lick the banana leaves? Whoa, I think this is going to be the tallest towel we've ever made. Excuse me, lizard. This is for Sefa. He's been working hard at sea for 10 days, and we always wait until he comes home before we eat it. Ah, Tooks! I didn't mean to eat the banana leaves. Come on, let's get you cleaned up. No eating, lizard. I mean it.
Jono, your house is so boring.
Well, what do you want to do?
What about play a prank on your sister? We could tie all her handbags together.
Nah, I don't think that's a good idea. Hey, I know. Do you want to help me choose some games for my birthday next week?
Games? Sure. You do realise you're hanging with the king of fun. What about limbo? I'm the best at that. We could even do the hardcore barbed wire version.
Yeesh! I was actually thinking board games could be fun.
Board games? How boring. What are you, 8 years old?
Yeah, actually I am.
Right. What's that sweet smell?
It's vakalolo. That stuff is delish! Oh, but I just remembered, we can't eat it till Dad gets home from his big fishing trip today. He'd be gutted if we took some.
Why do you have to wait for him? Is he bringing home some little fishies and some seaweed to sprinkle over it? Come on, man. It looks so good. Oh, man.
We can't eat it, Tyson. We gotta be strong.
Okay, bro. Strong.
Now, I'll go get the board games and show you what I've got.
No worries. I'll wait right here.
I mean,
no one's gonna notice if one teeny-weeny piece is missing. Oh, so good. I suppose just one more baby piece couldn't hurt anyone.
Party games, party games. Oh, malnourished mammals. Nah, it's only four player. Ooh, what about this classic? Twisty, a great party game. Mom really needs to stop buying our board games from the $2 bargain store. Okay, Tyson, I've got all the games out. Tyson, you didn't!
What's going on in here?
Tyson ate Dad's vakalolo.
What?
Maybe we can cook some more before he gets back. Oh, that's Dad! He's back!
Oh, I think I need the bathroom.
I'll get the door, you deal with him. Hey, Dad, welcome home.
Hey, Buna, meet my new friend.
Wow, that's an impressive fish.
Yeah, he's the biggest I've ever caught.
Good to have you home.
Oh, I missed you too, my little man.
I'm with Tooks. That thing stinks. Or is that you, Dad?
Oh, 10 days out at sea can do that to you. Do I smell vakalolo?
Do you want to tell Daddy Tooks, or should I?
Don't get too excited.
The vakalolo, what happened to it?
I think that's your answer.
Welcome home, Dad!
Jono, what happened?
It wasn't me, I promise! It was...
Hi, Mr. Chewy. You're back.
Tyson, did you eat all that vakalolo?
I technically didn't eat all of it.
Tyson, we spent all morning making that for Mr. Tui. You should know better than to take things without asking.
No one told me I couldn't.
I think it's time you went home, Tyson.
Yeah. Okay.
So, I guess no Vakalolo for me, huh?
Oh, unfortunately not. Jono, I don't want you spending any more time with Tyson. I'm sick of all the trouble he causes.
Oh, but my party's coming up and he's helping me with the plans.
No, Jono. He's always up to no good.
Oh!
Hey, Jono!
Hey, Costa.
They're giving out free serviettes and straws down at the food court. Thought you might be up for an adventure.
No, I just want to be on my own right now.
Well, that's okay. See you around.
Now, what are you doing out here in this cold, wet weather, boy?
I really just want to be on my own.
Are you upset about what happened with Tyson? Because that makes two of us.
It's not fair. He's one of my best friends. He just did one little thing, and now Mom probably won't let me see him for 1,000 years.
It's not just one little thing, Jono. Remember what happened on your fifth birthday?
I don't want to do it no more.
Don't be a wimp, Jono. 3, 2, 1, go! This is definitely going online.
I got a new bike after that, though.
Yes, but it doesn't change what Tyson did. Lucky it was only the roof that was damaged. And do you remember your sixth birthday?
Your mum made so much food, Jono.
Tastes awesome, too.
Gives me an idea. Food fight!
I don't know if your mother was more annoyed about that or what Tyson did on your seventh birthday.
Cool! $20!
I'll look after it for you, bro.
That's right! Lucky Mum sniffed out the thief!
Yes, but it should never have happened in the first place.
Maybe Tyson's not such a great friend.
Jono, don't overlook the great friends who will be at your party. It's going to be a fantastic day. And if Tyson's not there, what could go wrong?
Snacks, streamers, balloons. Looks like we have everything, Alinta.
Look, it's Tyson.
Hey, Tyson. Feeling better today?
Stay low. Look, my next victim is about to go down.
Tyson, that's dangerous.
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm looking after the community.
You can't do that. You're ruining my prank.
Watch me.
Well, I'll get you back. You just wait and see what I have in store for Jono's birthday.
Tyson, you won't be welcome at Jono's birthday. Don't you realise that treating others this way has consequences?
Whatever. It's just a bit of fun. Catch you at the party, salami.
I think that's just about it. Not yet, Tooks. The birthday boy gets first piece, but you can put that one on top. Not this time, Lizard. You're outside today.
Mom, I've put all the balloons up.
And I've got the entertainment sorted. Scoopity-doobity-doo. Where's the rabbit?
I'll get it. Oh, hi, Tyson. What are you doing here?
I'm here for the party, you bozo.
I can talk to him, Jono.
No, it's okay, Dad. Sorry, Tyson. But you're not invited to my party.
What? I thought we were friends. How are you going to have a party without the king of fun?
That's the problem. Your fun always seems to get someone else hurt. I don't want that at my party.
Fine. I didn't really want to come anyway. All those board games, I'd be bored out of my brain. I'm out of here.
Oh, I'm proud of you, son. Now let's get this party started.
Happy birthday, Jono. Here's your present.
Whoa. No way! Settlers of Cluedo?
Yep.
two of my favourite games collide. We so need to play it together sometime. And there's some straws and serviettes in there for you too.
Come in, guys. Mom says no Vakalolo until the birthday boy has had the first bit. Jono, all I got for my 2,000 game tokens was a cork and a plain notepad.
Ah, with the amount of tokens I've earned over the past year, you'd think I could buy the entire business off them. This is what I think of you, sand bottle.
Didn't get the prizes you wanted, eh?
We didn't get the prizes anyone would want.
Let me see. Not so bad. You know, with this bottle and this cork, you could make a bottle rocket.
What? How?
Easy. I used to make these with my bros all the time when I was your age.
Josepha, could I get your help, please?
Oh, I'm needed in the backyard. Here, I'll just scribble down the instructions. Here we go. Follow this. Mum has boxes of useful bits and pieces in the garage. See if you can launch this thing to the moon.
I'm gonna make one so awesome it could blast a hole through the ozone layer.
Yes, well, just make sure you don't blast a hole through the car window, eh? And please, don't aim it at each other.
Oh!
Josepha!
Just call out if you need anything, kids. I'll be in the backyard.
Jono, we need stuff to make a pump.
Got it all!
Hey!
I think we can take it from here.
I'm not sure if Dad would be happy about that.
Dad's bottle rocket design is fine, but I want this thing to be so powerful, it'll reach the moon and smack Neil Armstrong right between the eyes.
I don't think Neil Armstrong lives on the moon.
Of course he does. Stop being such a skeptic. Come on. Let's do it my way.
Okay.
Here, Tuks. You take a seed and make a little hole with your finger. Then drop the seed in and cover it.
Perfect, Tuks. How about you plant all the seeds in this garden bed?
There! I think we're done.
It looks a little odd, don't you think?
Nah, it looks great. Now to get it flying.
You're not going to set it off inside the garage, are you?
Of course I am, Salome. It needs a proper test run before we send it into outer space.
The last thing we want is for it to make a dent in the car. Lucky it didn't punch a hole in the car door. Dad would have gone off his rocket.
Ha ha! I see what you did there. We make a good team. Masters of good puns as well as good bottle rockets, eh?
Jono, the wall.
Looks like we've hit a brick wall.
You've hit a brick wall with your puns. This isn't funny anymore.
Should we pull it out?
I think we have to.
Here goes nothing. Do you think we can fix it?
Let's paint over it. Mum and Dad will never notice.
We could use this. It looks like the right colour.
Good idea. perfect. Ah! Jono, what is this stuff?
Acid.
We need to cover this up, and fast. We need
a poster. I'll be back. There.
That's a good cover-up. We just need to disguise it from the other side now.
I'm just going to the garage to get my shovel. Do you need anything?
Maybe my watering can?
Going well there, Tuis. Keep up the good work.
Hey, Dad. How's gardening going?
Oh, great. It's such a beautiful day to be outside. More importantly, how's the rocket going? Having any trouble with the instructions?
Oh, no. They're really easy to follow. Watch out, Neil Armstrong!
Jono, look!
What?
The hole! It's alive!
Ah!
Everything okay?
Are you looking for this?
Yes. Thanks, Salome. A Wombat Man poster. I didn't know your mum had one of these down here.
Mum? Oh, yeah. She's a real fan.
Well, there you go. You learn something new every day. Well, I'd better get back to it. Keep up the building.
Tuis! This hole, it's a secret. Do you know what that means?
It means don't tell Mum and Dad.
We need you, Tuis. You need to keep Mum and Dad away until we fix it, okay? That a boy.
So, what do we do now?
I don't know, but we need to come up with something, and fast.
We could just tell Mum and Dad. Dad could probably fix this hole in no time.
Are you serious? We've got this, Jono. Remember, we're doing this our way. We just need to find something stronger to cover the hole.
Did you get my watering can?
Oh, sorry. I forgot. Where is it again?
Up on the front veranda, I think. Or maybe in the garage.
Okay, I'll be right back. Oh, Tukana, my boy. Whew. Your plants are growing already. Nothing suspicious about that.
Ha ha! There!
I'm sure I just heard tapping. Did you hear that, Tuis?
Ah!
Are you two okay? You look a little stiff.
Yep, fine. We're just doing some stretching. Building rockets is hard work.
Okay. Have you two seen Mum's watering can?
It's just over there.
Over where?
Over there!
Oh, yes. I see.
Salome, we can patch up the hole with that.
You're supposed to add water to it.
No time for that, Master Chef. I just wanted to say that your car is in perfectly good condition.
How on earth did this happen? You could never have built something this destructive with my instructions. Did you let your rocket off inside?
I can't believe this.
Don't worry, Marita. I'll find you another Wombat Man poster. As for you kids...
Sorry, Dad. Things just got a little out of control.
You can fix it, can't you, Dad?
Of course I can. That's what dads do.
3, 2, 1... Take that, outer space!
come a time for sleepy pies. Come on, Tucana. Time for sleepy pies. Off you go.
Dad! Salome stole my favorite shirt!
It was my shirt first.
Your shirt? It has a J for Jono on the front. Unless your name is Jalome.
Kids, kids. Can't you see I'm trying to get your little brother down for a nap right now?
But, Dad, Jono has two of these shirts. He's not even using this one right now.
Look, if you kids just be quiet for 5 minutes, I've got something I want to give you.
Like a surprise?
Just 5 minutes, please.
No peeking until I count to three. One,
two, three.
Surprise!
It's
Oh, since when is a lizard a surprise?
No, up there!
A tree house? Dad, did you build that?
Oh, it's a certified Tuis construction. Built to last.
That's awesome! This is the best tree house in the street, if not the entire world!
Why? It's nobody's birthday.
You're both always hanging out with other kids in the neighbourhood. And we thought you needed somewhere to meet up and do your community projects together.
Wow, this is so cool.
I'm going to live here and raise a family here.
What's all this stuff?
Just some tubs of random supplies, like sewing gear, craft stuff, recipe books.
And my video game console from when I was a young boy, the Bubble Hoop 64.
This thing? Kids in your day must have been so bored. Oh, wait, I almost got it. Ah, I got it. Oh, no. Lost the other one.
You'll get there, boy. It is possible. Just don't erase my high scores, eh?
So what do you think we do with this place, Jono?
Yeah, I don't know.
Mum and Dad wanted us to use this place for good. Maybe we could turn it into a hair salon. We could have all the mirrors along this wall, a bench along here, and let's paint the walls hot pink. Oh, we'll need something better than this to make curtains. Come on, Jono, we're going to the mall. Pink material, pink paint, a fluffy doormat.
This is a treehouse, not a flamingo.
Sorry, Tiana. They said they just don't fix these anymore.
But why?
They say it's cheaper just to buy a new one.
But I like this one. It's special.
I know, Tiana. Sometimes things are just too broken to be fixed.
What rubbish!
That's harsh, Jono.
No. I mean, that music box could be fixed. I could probably do it with my eyes closed.
Dr. Jonathan, hey? The toy doctor?
Sure am. All I need now is...
a hospital!
Dr. Jono, we have our first patient and it's not looking good.
Bring him over.
Costa, what happened?
Beady-eyed Petey ate a bit too much curry last night.
Leave him with us and we'll have him looking as good as new in no time.
You know, I think I have a whole lot of toys that could do with repairs. I'll be back.
Jono, can you put him on charge and schedule him for surgery in, 20 minutes?
Yeah, I'll be there tomorrow.
Ugh, thanks for your help, Jono. Hey, Alinta, what's the problem here?
Stacy Sparkle has portal hypertensive gastropathy.
Oh, I can sew her a new pink dress.
Brilliant.
Come and take a bed, Stacy Sparkle. I'll have you sorted soon. Oh, hello.
Can you fix this? It used to light up and have all these cool sayings, but even with new batteries, it doesn't work anymore.
Oh, okay. Well, I can knit him a cute sweater.
Is that a metamorphob robot?
Metamorphob robot 5000?
Step aside, Salome. I can fix this one.
Online.
There you go.
Thanks, guys. Keep up the great work. Our town needs you.
Look at them, Sepha. And look at all those kids.
I knew they had it in them. What kids can do when they work together for good.
Incoming emergency!
My little brother stuck an incompatible action figure down my T-Rex's throat, and I can't get it out.
To the operating theatre!
Wondering if you might be able to fix my music box. My grandma gave this to me and nobody seems to be able to fix it.
Just give him a few of these to help with the pain for now.
Oh, your T-Rex has something stuck in it. My brother used to have one of these and I was always getting things unstuck for him. It looks really tricky, but if you just do this and this, voila!
Oh, yeah!
That was amazing! We could really use your talent around here. What would you say about joining the team?
I'd love to.
And here's your music box, good as new.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Everyone is working together on something great. Absolutely nothing can go wrong.
The hospital can be rebuilt, you know.
But how long will that take? Our hospital is nothing without the treehouse. It might be days, months, years before it's rebuilt.
Oh, eh. Doesn't this look like a sorry sight? I know you'd both put so much effort into the Treehouse Hospital. You did a wonderful job and you helped not only a lot of toys, but a lot of kids too.
But now it's all gone.
Salome, it was only a building. You see, what made the treehouse special was not the treehouse itself. It was all you kids and the kindness you showed. There's no storm that can take that away. Come to the veranda, you two. I want to show you something.
The hospital. Everyone is...
See? You don't need a building to make a difference. You just need a bit of teamwork and big hearts.
Come on, Salome! Let's join them!
Thank you.
Tux, it's way past your bedtime. Why can't you sit still?
Hey, Dad. So, I realised that we never thanked you for building the treehouse for us.
Oh, hey. It's okay, Salome.
No, Dad. Thank you so much. All of us kids decided to make you a little gift out of some of the extra bits and pieces we had lying around. It's nothing amazing, but I'm sure you could use it.
Oh, Salome, thanks. You're a good egg. Oh, wow.
You can unpack this box.
It's been so long since we had Remembrance Feast at our place. What is all this stuff?
A lot of it is sentimental. It helps us remember important times and people from our lives. This tablecloth was woven by my great auntie.
What does this remind you of?
Oh, that reminds me that your father is terrible at buying wedding anniversary gifts. It's not meant to be in there. Whoa! Be careful with that, Salome.
Sorry.
It's okay. That cup is just pretty special.
How come?
Your dad made this with his father, your pa, when he was probably about your age. When pa died, it was one of the few things he kept that belonged to him.
They're here!
Already?
Jono, Salome, Tux.
Whoa! Nanda, Ratu, Penny, welcome.
Can I help with your bag?
That's very kind of you, Salome. My feet are aching.
Come in and we'll see what we can do to fix that.
So, are we all ready for the big night? The place looks a little bare.
I'm just finishing up a few things.
Well, let's get you settled in. You'll have Salome and Jono's room.
Thanks, you two. I sure could do with a nap. Hey, nice stuff. Can't wait for tonight.
Jono, Salome, I'm gonna need some help. I still have to shop and cook, and we haven't done any setup.
Don't worry, Mum. We are at your service.
If you could get the foot spa out for Nanda and decorate, I can get to the shops.
Too easy.
Oh, thank you. I'll get the foot spa.
Need some help?
Oh, whoa. No, I've got it.
Okay, I'm just going down to the garage to fix something up. I'll be there if you need me.
Hard at work, Salome?
Ah! Ah! Oh, sorry, Nanda. Wait, let me help you. This is beautiful. Did you make it?
Yes, Yava. It's been a bit of an ongoing project. I've been sewing a symbol on the blanket to represent everyone in our family for years. It helps me remember to keep you all in my prayers. Look, here's yours.
A bee?
You are always humming away, busy doing something. And whatever you do ends up being something sweet.
Wow, that's nice.
This weekend, I need to finish Tux's symbol. I've been so sick lately, I got behind. So today is the day.
Can't wait to see it. Jono, what have you been doing? Jono?
And here, Seth!
What are you doing in the fridge?
It's a long story. Well, actually, it's a pretty short story. I was decorating, then got distracted and climbed in the fridge.
Ugh, you're not being very helpful. Where's the cup?
What cup?
Dad's special cup. The one that belonged to Grandpa.
I haven't seen any cup.
It couldn't have just walked away. You must have done something with it. You didn't break it, did you?
No, honest, it wasn't me. I've just been chilling the whole time.
Oh no, someone must have taken it.
You know what I reckon?
What?
We have a thief. Think about it, Salome. Everyone arrives and then the next thing you know, the special cup disappears.
But who would steal it?
I don't know, but we're gonna find out. Right, let's get down to business. Who was the last person you saw with the cup?
Penny looked at all the boxes on the table, remember, on his way to the bedroom.
There you go! Suspect number one! Ha-ha! Caught you red-handed!
Ah, what? I swear I didn't eat all the in-flight peanuts.
Ugh, it's just Benji.
Ah, I must have left him in my bed. Sorry, Penny.
Okay, Penny is off the list. Any other suspects?
As I was starting to set up, I do remember hearing a very suspicious humming noise.
Nanda!
Look at that hair! You could hide a watermelon in that do. In fact, I think I can see something. We gotta check it out.
How are we gonna search her hair without her knowing?
I have the perfect plan.
All ready, Nanda.
That's perfect.
Okay, Nanda. Call out if you need anything.
Oh, I was wondering where that got to.
Nanda is out. But look!
Either Tux is hiding something in there or he has been very, very busy.
Well, well, well. If it isn't Mr. Robber Nappy Pants, we know what's going on in there. Hand over the goods!
Tux, how can you live like that?
Well, that's Tux off the list. That just leaves one more suspect.
Ratu!
Hey, what are you two up to?
More importantly, what are you up to?
I was just,
Sounding a bit suspicious, Uncle Ratu. May I ask, what were you hiding in your bag?
I'd prefer not to say.
Is that because it doesn't belong to you?
It doesn't belong to me, but...
It's him. We've found the thief.
What? Thief? I'm no thief. Here, see? I bought this nice new set of cutlery for your family as a thank you for hosting Remembrance Feast. The duty-free prices are amazing. Thought they would be a nice addition to the meal tonight.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Uncle Ratu.
What's all this about anyway?
Dad's special cup has gone missing. It was right out there on the table and now it's gone.
Oh, I think I've got some information that might help.
Really?
As I was walking past the table, I noticed the cup, but it was broken.
It wasn't broken this morning.
So the thief is not just a thief, but a vandalizer!
Why don't we return to the scene of the crime and see what evidence we can find?
I'm back!
How's setup going?
I wasn't quite sure where everything was meant to go.
Oh, that's okay. Hey, where's Dad's cup?
Right here, Marita. I think Tux had a little accident, but it's all fixed now.
So it was Dad all along.
I would like to thank you all for coming to Remembrance Feast this year. Today is a special day where we remember what we have lost and celebrate all the blessings we have gained. Today we eat and drink together, giving thanks for our values and our family. So please, join with me.
Well said, Zephyr. Solomoni would be so proud of you.
Hey, Nanda, did you finish the blanket? I'm a bee.
Sure did.
What is Tux?
I decided he would be a canoe.
Tux is a canoe?
Yeah, he's a brave little guy who's always up for an adventure. And you never know what he may be able to hold.
I was wondering where my sunglasses went.
And my phone.
Tux!
Welcome to the 50th annual Junior Sandcastle Building Competition.
Or the Edgebusic, for short.
The rules are simple. We put 1 hour on the clock, and the team with the tallest sandcastle at the end wins. This year, we have some of the finest young builders in the district competing for the ultimate trophy. We'll fix that later. Let's meet our teams. First up, we have the High Twins, Emma and Emily.
And qualifying for their first time ever, Jimba and Alinta.
And qualifying solely by the beautiful handwriting on their application form, Nick and Costa Kappa.
And of course, the Tui kids, Salome and Jonathan.
We also have our coach for this year.
Yes, we do, Penny. Please welcome 7-time Junior Sandcastle winner, Josepha Dewey. He will be in close communication with our chief lifeguard and keeper of the coast, Pa Eli.
We are in safe hands today.
I believe you are forgetting someone.
There seems to be another coach.
Another coach?
Indeed. I am 1-time semi-finalist Peter Kappa.
Should have been twice if it wasn't for that Todd Hennessy.
Okay. Let's get on with the competition. Let the building begin!
About time, hey Tux.
The first part of building a sandcastle is choosing some good real estate.
Yes, signified by the putting of the spade into the sand.
Hey, kids, don't build down near the water. Come further inland.
But everyone's building down there.
Trust me. I'm 7-time champion, remember? You don't want to be building down there today.
Hey, girls, did you hear? We need to build further up this way.
And build a sandcastle with dry sand? You're already trying to sabotage us, Jonathan.
I wasn't. I did.
Yeah, Jono. Quit trying to camouflage us.
With all the teams finding their ideal spot, it's now time to see how they're going to form the foundations of their sandcastles.
Hey, Ratu, Penny, can one of you help me down to the water? I want to splash my feet.
Mom, we're trying to do the commentary thing. Can it wait?
Oh, thanks, Tux. Ah, Tux, your castle is coming along nicely.
Wow, the teams this year are trying a new method with their groundwork. Seashells.
That's it, kids. They will do nicely.
Hey, kids. Use rocks.
Rocks?
But the rocks are all so far away.
Just trust me. There's no foundation stronger than a rock.
Rocks? Don't listen to him, kids. By the time they're done collecting rocks, you'll have a skyscraper.
I have to say, Ratu,
It is a beautiful day for sandcastle building.
That water looks divine. Ratu, Benny, are you free yet?
We really do have some high-class talent in today's competition. It looks like Jimber and Alinta are getting a huge lead over the rest of the teams.
See, what did I tell you?
These are some fantastic foundations, everyone. I did warn them.
They didn't think of the little crabs.
Just like that, they've gone from first to last. They'll need a miracle to come back from here. Jimbo will be absolutely...
Hold that thought, bro. They're now moving on to one of my favorite parts of sandcastle building. Fortification.
Ah, yes. To those watching the tournament for the first time, this is the process of reinforcing the walls of the castle to prevent it from toppling over.
Oh, who could forget the great sandcastle fall of 98?
I know Peter won't forget.
That's Coach Peter to you.
Dad, you've won this thing before.
Technically, I've never...
What do you think we should use to strengthen our castle?
You can't go past seaweed. Grab some from over there and twist it through the sand.
Hey, boys. I'd give the seaweed a miss, eh? The birds around here love that stuff. Try some driftwood instead.
Don't be ridiculous, Josepha. Who ever heard of a seagull eating seaweed?
Oh, I'm not worried about the seagull.
Now that's entertainment. Did you see that pelican, Tux?
So many exciting twists and turns in this competition as the Kappa kids fall behind.
It looks like the final two contenders are the twins and the Tuis. With only 10 minutes left, this competition could come right down to the wire.
I don't know, Ratu. I think Emma and Emily have got this. Go, twins!
Not sure I'm a fan of your biased commentary, bro.
Emma, Emily, I really recommend you move to another location.
And start again? With 10 minutes to go? Are you crazy?
I don't think we can do this, Salome. Those twins are just too good.
Don't give up, guys. You've got this. Come on.
I wouldn't be so sure, Josepha. There's only 15 seconds left on the clock.
It's coming in. When? Now.
Oh! Watch out!
Watch out! Here comes the king tide.
Finish! So much drama! The Tui kids take the win with only seconds to go!
We won! We won!
We did it!
We won!
Who would have thought? A king tide!
Who would have thought, eh?
Finally, some cool water on my toes. Oh no! Ratu! Benny! I really do need help! Ratu!
And so concludes the 50th annual Junior Sandcastle Competition. Ratu, any final thoughts?
Yes. What do you want for dinner on the way home?
I meant final thoughts about today's competition. Oh, yeah. Who won again? Salome and Jono. How much love, niece and nephew.
They won? Yay! That's great news!
It was literally a few minutes ago, Ratu.
There you go. So, what are we getting on the way home for dinner?
I'll get it!
series with a double kick? Yeah, it is.
Woo! Castle trucks, emu wheels, epic fives and...
And it's a Josh Pratt signed edition. Mum and Dad gave it to me this morning as an early birthday present.
Oh, man, you scored. You'll be able to do any trick you want to on that thing.
Yeah, I'm just got to be super careful so I don't scratch up the artwork.
You boys ready to try out the new skate park?
Oh, sure am. Come on, let's go.
We might need to fix that up.
Wow, this place is epic.
Look at that giant pole.
Oh, Tux, look. They have a park just for you. Who do you reckon they are?
Whoa! They must be the pros.
Pros? I could do that in my sleep.
Yeah, right, Jono. I'd like to see you try.
Oh, watch me.
Not so fast, kids. The sign. Bikes, scooters and skateboards allowed. Helmets and pads must be worn. One person at a time on all obstacles. All riders must skate in their designated age area.
Skateboards allowed! That's all I need to know!
Jono, you need to wear a helmet and pads?
Oh, well, that's just bad luck, eh? 'Cause I didn't bring any.
Oh, neither did I!
Lucky for you, I have thought of everything. Salome, you take Tux to the under three area. Jono, you wait right here. I'm going to get you boys helmets and pads from the car.
Helmets and pads are for losers.
Let me fix your helmet, Tux. You need to be able to see. There. Let's try this first ramp. Hop on. Go, Tux. Should we try again? Yeah, I guess that was pretty lame. You want to try the big one? Maybe we should wait for Mum. All right.
Whoa! That was sick!
What are yous doing? Too chicken to try out the ramps.
No, Jono's mum is just getting us helmets and pads.
And taking forever.
Just ride without him. It's only the Unco kids who really need him.
But the sign, it says...
The sign is just there to stop babies from breaking their legs. Are you babies?
No.
Well then, what are you waiting for?
He's right, Costa. Let's go.
But we can't go there, Jono. It's for kids over 12.
Oh, but that's where all the fun stuff is.
You coming or what?
I just don't want to risk. Okay.
Not again, Tux. Ugh. Where is Mum? Hey, Tux, do you want to see a really big ramp? Wow! Look at that, Tux! Aren't they amazing? No, we can't skate here, Tux. Is that Jono?
Who's coming with me this time?
Thanks, but I'm happy to wait.
For what? Not the helmets.
I think we're meant to go one at a time.
Who's got a new Josh Pratt Prudic? He doesn't want to get the beak scratched, eh?
Ah, well, you're lost.
Wow, that was a pretty gnarly trick.
That was nothing. You should try, Jono.
I'd like to see you try.
I'll show you, Salome.
Just keep your legs bent and relax. Feel the flow and ride with it. Then when you... Yeah, you know what?
Just
just do what she does.
Please be careful, Jono. That trick looks really dangerous.
Nah, you'll be fine. You got this, man.
Jono, you are not meant to be here. Mum said you had to wait.
Try and stop me, Salome. Anyway, aren't you meant to be looking after Tux?
I am. Tux? Tux! Tux!
Prepare to be dazzled, Salome.
Jono, wait! Tux!
Woohoo! Did you see that? Costa? Hey, Costa.
Hey, Jono.
How are you feeling?
Yeah, okay. Doctors say I can go home tomorrow.
That's great. Sorry, man. I tried to fix your skateboard. I don't think anyone will notice the scratches anymore.
Thanks, Jono.
Oh, yo, is this Costa's room?
Yeah, that's me.
I'm Kaz. I saw what went on yesterday. Wanted to check you're in one piece.
Yeah, fractured, but still in one piece.
Oh, that's lucky. I've seen some beat-up falls in my day.
Wait, are you the skater who does the flips?
Yep, that's me. I run the skate school at the park.
You make those jumps look so easy.
I've had loads of practice. You were the little dude who tried the aerial, right? You've got guts trying that in a bowl that size.
Yeah, I guess.
You should.
Yeah, I know, I know. I suppose this is where you tell me I should have been wearing my helmet and pads and being in the right area.
I wasn't going to say any of that. I've broken my fair share of rules.
Finally! Someone who agrees with me. Those rules at the park are stupid, eh? They ruin all the fun.
I used to think so, until I realised rules are there to help me have an awesome time that doesn't include a hospital trip. What I was going to say was that you guys would be welcome to join the crew, but just a heads up, we follow park rules.
No problemo.
That would be awesome.
And I think we have some spare boards, Costa, if you need one.
Thanks. But mine has matching scars.
Did you stack it too?
Nah, that's my prosthetic. Told you I was a rule breaker. I just didn't come out of my accident as well as you. Not to worry, didn't stop me. Catch ya.
Got this, Jono.
Don't you even think about it.
Well, it's now or never.
Okay, Jono, just do what we've been practicing. Ready in 3, 2, 1, go!
Woohoo! I'm okay!
Good to go again?
Sure am.
But not before me.
Okay, Costa, just like we practiced. 3, 2, 1, go! Awesome!
Yeah! Woo-hoo-hoo!
Okay, everyone, who's up for an ice cream?
Oh, yeah!
Elle, you didn't find these in the car, did you?
Ready, boys? The last one there gets the wonky ice cream.
Oh, yeah!
Jonathan, want to come outside and kick the footy around?
Busy studying.
You're not studying. You're reading comics.
Correction. I am reading a brick blocks catalogue.
Brick blocks? Building blocks are for babies.
Correction.
The small pieces in a brick block set are a major choking hazard. These are premium collectible items for people aged 4 to 100. Are dragons for babies, Salome? Are giant battling brick bots for babies? Would a baby even care for a deep sea explorer sub-surrounded by exotic sea creatures?
No, look at those cute little dolphins. And those two little crabs are getting married. Let's get it.
Look at the price tag.
$400?
Like I said, Salome, it's a premium collectible 5,000-piece set designed for adults who've lost control of their finances.
We can pitch in and buy this together, Jono. How much money have you got?
$10 minus 10.
Huh?
I owe this one to Costa. Mother, you are looking quite splendid today.
Oh, thank you, Jonathan.
Not that you don't usually look nice. I mean, you always look great, Mum, but
Stick to the script, Jono.
Oh, yeah, could we please have a mere $200 each in order to purchase an item that will unify us as brother and sister and keep us quiet for most of the day? We will repay you with hugs, more than usual, and Salome will babysit your kind of twice a week for a year so you and Dad can get some much-needed respite. Additionally, I will do my very best at school.
Jono, Salome, if you want to buy something for that much, go for it. But you'll need to raise the funds yourselves.
I don't think we could ever raise that much.
I wouldn't be so sure. Jono's old friend Tyson made a small fortune selling chocolate bars by the side of the road.
Wait a second. They say not for individual sale.
We have loads of bananas that aren't getting eaten. Maybe you could make some banana bread and sell it to our neighbours.
That's it, Jono. If we can sell 200 pieces of banana bread for $2 each, that's,
$1 million!
No, we can actually do this, Jono. I'll follow this recipe and you can peel the bananas for me.
Okie dokie!
Maybe you can collect these ingredients from the cupboards instead.
Okay. I don't think we have any bicarb soda.
Never mind. If you can't cook, I have just the job for you.
It's kind of hot in here, Lomé.
I'm the chef and you're the head of promotion and marketing. Now dance.
To wear the suit. You're the dancer.
Because we need to attract a crowd. Don't give me that look.
Fine.
It's working, Jono.
Banana bread, eh? So, what is it? Banana flavored bread or banana shaped like bread?
You've never had banana bread before?
Nope. But there is a first time for everything. I'll take 4. Thanks, Salome. And keep up the dancing, Josefa.
It's me, Jonathan.
Huh. I thought for sure those unmistakable legs belonged to your dad. See you, kids.
We did it. Our first sale.
I'll take your word for it, Lome.
Hey, guys. I was wondering if I could trade a jar of honey for a slice of banana bread.
That sounds like a great offer. But we're actually just trying to save some money for a brick block set.
And did you know that honey is actually bee vomit?
Who are you talking to, Jono?
Oh, you guys are over there.
I love those brick block sets. I would like to try one of the big ones one day, but they're very expensive. I might come back another time. That sure does smell good. See you guys.
Whoa! There it is. I told you there was a giant piece of toast dancing outside the Tui house.
I'm a big slice of banana bread, not toast.
Meh, whatevs. How's business, Lome?
Not bad. We just had our first customer.
How long have you guys been here?
About 5 minutes.
Really? 5 minutes and only one customer? Sounds like a waste of time to me. Come on, Ems, let's go.
We just got an order for 100 slices. Quick, Jono, get out of that suit and back in the kitchen.
Yes, ma'am.
Did you see that, sis? They just sold 100 slices of banana bread. I think we just discovered quite a profitable enterprise.
With my cooking skills and your silky smooth dancing legs on show, I reckon we should be able to get that brick block set by the end of the weekend. Uh-oh. What's that? Oh, great. Competition.
What's going on, Salome?
We're going to find out.
How's business going, Toasty Tuis? It would appear there's only space for one food stall in this street. Ha! Yeah! Does that mean we have to pack up our stall?
Fair is fair. This street is reserved for banana bread.
Banana bread? Ha!
We were here first!
I don't know about that. I've been selling yogurt since I was 5.
I've been making banana bread since I was 3.
I've been making yogurt since before you were born.
I'm older than you.
You're not older than the both of us combined.
Ugh.
That'll help, girls.
Well, if it's war you want, it's war you'll get. Come on, Jono.
Ow!
How's business going?
Very well, actually. We reached our target and have just about sold out.
Really? So you're closing up shop?
Our business plans are none of your concern. Anyway, what brings you to the other side?
Just a bit of snooping. Emma, but that's what you said. What I meant to say was... shopping? Now I think about it, I'd love to try a piece of your banana bread. Emma! I am only buying it so we can taste how bad it is. No, Emma, give it back. No, I want to try.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
Emily, Emma, stop fighting. Someone's going to get hurt.
I'll fight. Go, Emma. You show her who's boss.
Ah! That actually looks pretty good.
Banana bread and yogurt. Genius!
Can someone tell me what's going on?
This is amazing! The ultimate fusion!
We can join forces. Tui and Twins Proprietary Limited. What do you say?
Ew. Ew. This is great, but it's missing something.
What do you want?
We'd like to make an investment in your bee puke business.
Oh, sure. But I thought you don't do trades.
Will this sweeten the deal?
Oh, wow, sure!
Ah! Whoa!
don't miss your once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to meet John Brown, the creator of Wombat Man. Appearing one time only, this...
Sunday Arvo, 1 p.m.
Don't miss it!
Run this red light?
Jono, for the last time, I'm not going to run a red light. Or a stop sign. Or that children's crossing. We'll make it to the mall in time. Just enjoy the wait. That's half the fun with these things anyway.
Standing in line with a bunch of sweaty people? Ugh, no thanks. I'm feeling like a new top is calling my name.
Wombat Man is life, Salome! Ah, Dad! That light was orange!
So, what did you bring to get signed?
What?
Did you bring your favourite comic? The one with the robots?
That's their name?
Or your Wombat Man poster, eh?
Ewan told me he would sign stuff!
Duh, that's why you wait in line?
I thought it was just to say hi or something!
Here, you could get his signature on this if you like.
You know what? Thanks, Dad. I will.
Uh-oh.
Oh, you've gotta be kidding me!
Okay, kids. I'll drop you off here and go and search for a park. Buna, you're going to have to wait with Jono until I come back, okay?
With the sweaty people?
With the sweaty people, sweetie. I won't be long. Oh, come on.
Hey, Jono! Lome!
Oh, man! You got a pretty sweet spot.
Yeah, I saved you and your dad a spot too with these.
Thanks, bro. But it's me and Lome for now. We're not cutting. We're not cutting. Our friends save spots for us with these. Two, what time did you get here?
What time is it now?
1:02.
A couple of minutes ago.
Man, and already there's more joining the queue. This is gonna be big.
Yep. What time was he meant to be here?
One.
Yeah, that's what I thought too.
I wonder why he's late.
Maybe there's some oldie driving real slow in front of him.
Oh, my dad hates when that happens.
Oh, come on. Is the whole town out here today? Come on. It's okay, Zephyr. Calm, Zephyr. You can do this. Ooh.
Hey, where are you going?
Man, my body clock is telling me it's time to go.
John Brown is coming!
Yeah, but he's not here now, and that food is. So...
You don't want to meet him?
Yeah, maybe next time.
Wait, Nick! We can take your spot, yeah? Yes!
Ah, progress!
Why isn't this line moving? I've been stuck here for ages.
I don't know if John Brown is ever gonna come, Jono.
Oh, don't say that, Salome. He has to. He said he was coming, and he'll be here.
I'm just saying,
It's now almost 2 hours past when he was meant to be here. That sounds like he's not coming to me.
Where are you going?
I've got better things to do.
Oh, but Dad said you have to stay with us until he gets here.
You'll be fine, Jono. He's just there.
But Lomé, it's Wombat Man. We've read all of them together.
See ya.
It's okay, Jono. John Brown's coming. I know it too. I don't know if he's coming, Jono.
Oh, not you too.
I'm not leaving. I'm just seeing a lot of people going. Maybe they know something we don't? Hey, excuse me. Is Mr. Brown coming?
2.5 hours of my life wasted.
Hey! Hey, kid! You like Wombat Man, right? Do you want to stand with us and meet Mr. Brown? Get the vibes going?
Okay, old girl. This is gonna hurt me more than it hurts you.
Job. You've got to stay here and hold our spot.
Mr. Tuis! Mr. Tuis!
Costa, how was Wombat Man?
Actually, that's why I'm here. We need you to give up this car spot.
But it's taken me hours to get this.
I know, because there's someone else who's been looking for one for hours too.
Wombat Man?
Wombat Man!
John Brown's here!
No, he's not.
Yes he is, sir. I just saw him. It's not too late to meet a hero and get some swag. Come on, everyone. Nick, have you seen Lomé?
Nah, bro. What's with the running?
John Brown's here!
Right on, bro. Good for you.
Lomé! 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 Lomé!
Not cutting! Here, I saw this and thought it would look good with a signature on it. I got one for me too.
You will not believe the trouble I had getting a park. I hope your dad remembered to get fuel, kid.
It's a little big, but you'll grow into it.
That's the best T-shirt ever, Lomé. Hey, Dad, I got a bumper sticker for you.
Thanks, Johnny. I'm glad it all worked out for you kids. Now, let's get out of here before we get stuck in a traffic jam. Oh, no.
week of school holidays. I think your dad has something in mind for us to do today.
Sorry, fam. I've made some pretty concrete plans to plug my brain into the console and play Battlecraft online for at least the next 3 days straight. Woohoo!
Yeah, sorry, Dad. I'm planning to just chill.
You're gonna have to put your plans on hold, kids, because I've got 5 tickets to the hottest gig in town.
Battlecraft Esports Global Arena!
No. The Puddle Puggles, live in concert.
What?
Well, best be off. Gotta limber up my fingers for battle.
Not today, Jono. Your father spent good money on these tickets, and we're all going.
Ugh, this is gonna be the worst day ever. That was the best show ever. For a kid's show, I mean.
Yeah. My favourite bit was when the echidna puppet, what's his name? Stuck his head in that bucket of water and then that thing happened with the, hilarious.
Those singers were excellent. And the dancers, they reminded me a bit of you, Salome.
Really?
I give the show 5 stars. What did you think, Tux? 10. Cheer!
You kids are free to go and chill or do whatever now.
Jono, let's do a live show. What do you think?
Nah, I was gonna... the games can wait. Let's do it. I know, we can call it Jono and Friends.
Mm-mm, not Jono and Friends.
Jonathan and Friends?
No.
Jono and Fiends! We can take out the R!
Something without Jono in the title?
Friends?
How about 3, 2, 1, Blammo!
Yeah! I don't know what that means, but yeah!
The stage is set, the chairs are lined up. What next?
We gotta figure out what we're actually doing. I was thinking you could be the dancer.
Yep, definitely.
And I could be the puppet. But I don't have a puppet.
Here. G'day, kids. I'm Socky J. Sockwell.
Oh, brilliant! Maybe I'll get my own sock.
Now we just need someone who can play music.
Hey, what's up, Tuis?
Costa, can you play the guitar?
Never picked one up in my life.
You're hired! Welcome to the team. You're getting a sweet sound out of that, Costa.
Step, step, up to the left. Step, step, up to the left.
Hey, guys, you have a full audience. I think they're ready for the show to begin.
Let's do this.
It's the 3-2-1 Blammo Show with special guests Salome Tui and Costa Campbell. Yeah!
Old MacDonald had a farm and Bingo was his name.
Oh,
with
everybody.
A bingo
they're
here and a bingo there. Here a bing, there a go, everywhere a bingo.
Come on.
Rose, what's that smell? I wasn't expecting it to be good, but I was expecting it to not be terrible. I want my money back.
But the show was free.
Bravo, encore.
Thanks, Dad, but we were terrible. You can go inside and watch your football game now.
Oh, no. It's already started.
Maybe we could invest in another string for the guitar. That could make a difference.
Maybe I could use my other sock. I think my other foot is less stinky.
It's not that, guys. We're just not good enough. None of us can sing, dance, or perform.
The Puddle Puggles!
What's a puddle?
Hey, I'm not from around here.
Do you kids know where the nearest...
It's Jason!
Jason? From the puddle?
We loved your show. We saw it last week.
Oh, awesome. Glad you liked it. You know, that show raised heaps of money for charity. So we're super happy with how it all turned out too.
Oh, cool.
Did you guys put on a show or something?
Tried to. Costa tried playing Old MacDonald with a single string guitar. Jono invaded the air with his sock stench, and I danced like a newborn giraffe.
You were way worse than a newborn giraffe.
I'm sure you guys aren't that bad. You probably just need the right gear. Here, come with me. Dancing around in those old sneakers is always going to end in disaster. Here, take these dance shoes. They'll make a huge difference, I promise.
Wow, thank you so much.
I have heaps of puppets that don't get used. Maybe you'd like to have this little guy.
Wow, thank you. I shall name him Crunch. I am Crunch. Give me all your food. Crunch, 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 crunch.
Hey, do you reckon you could treat this one extra special for me?
Yeah?
This is my 12-string guitar. I'd like you to have it.
Whoa, 12 strings? Thank you so much. I'll be so careful with it and look after it every day.
Take this as well. You'll need to hear those beautiful singing voices over the loud guitar.
This is so kind. I don't know how we can repay you.
No need. They're gifts. And who knows? You might find a way to spread the kindness around. Also, do you kids know where the nearest petrol station is?
That way?
Okay. Thanks anyway.
Wow! This is gonna be the best show ever! Is anyone there yet?
Not yet.
Everyone's probably on their way. Costa, did you decide on a charity?
Yep. Out of Rabid Rabbit Rescue, Pages Without Borders, Teeth for the Old Timers, and Save the Things, I thought Teeth for Old Timers probably sounds the most deserving. And if my papo is anything to go by, I might need them one day.
Don't tell me they're doing another show. Should be called 3-2-1 Lamo.
We can hear you.
You don't seriously think people will come and see your show after the performance you put on the other day?
We admit we were a little rusty, but we also didn't have awesome dancing shoes.
Or a 12-string guitar. Or Mr. Crunch.
Wait, you have sound explosion microphones?
Yeah.
Why are they still in the box?
We were having a little trouble setting them up, and singing is not really our strong point.
Do you realise how much these are worth? They are like top-of-the-line microphones.
How do you know?
We have a bit of a secret hobby. We like to sing.
Great! We need all the talent we can get!
You want us to sing in your show?
There's no point in having a gift that you don't share.
What do you say?
We're in.
It's the 3-2-1 Blammo Show, starring Salome, the fully developed giraffe, Costa Kemper, the music man, and his 12 strings of all. Effects. And of course,
Bravo! Bravo! Encore! Bravo! Well done, kids.
Just been having a nap.
Okay, well, Penny and I have some news. Do you want to tell him, Penny?
We are now the proud owners of the Grand Garden Resort.
A resort?
Yeah.
Where?
In Australia, down the road from you guys.
But you're in Fiji. You bought a place without looking at it first.
We sealed the deal after looking at the photos online. I've just emailed them to you. It looks amazing. Anyway, we gotta fly. We've got lots of work to do at the resort. We'll see you down under.
What was that about?
Uncle Roger and Penny bought a resort.
A resort? They can't afford a resort.
It actually looks pretty decent. Look at these photos.
Sefa!
Pretty impressive, eh?
Very impressive. This does look impressive.
Who's ready for the grand tour?
Yes, yes. Come on, let's go.
Here you go, Tukana.
Let me welcome you to the Grand Garden Resort.
This doesn't look like the photos.
Right this way, everyone. These are the beautiful Lee Newton villas. And if you're really lucky, you'll get the executive suite. It has colour television.
These look, great, Uncle Penny.
Whoa, Ratu, can you add another packet of sticky tack to the shopping list? If our guests need to relax those tired muscles, they can spend some time at the Lee Newton Pool and Spa.
Who is Lee Newton?
I don't know.
That water looks a little brown.
Yes. That's because these aren't just any spa baths. They are mud baths.
Really?
Oh! My paw sting!
Let's direct our attention over here.
Is this the pool?
Was the pool. We decided it would make a better skate park.
Cowabunga!
Gnarly.
But how do the water slides work if there's no water?
They're regular slides with an extra cushy exit. We're not short on entertainment here. Introducing the Lee Newton Mini Golf Course.
17 holes of family fun and putting madness.
There's no 18th hole?
We couldn't find it under all the overgrown grass.
I didn't know synthetic grass could grow.
This is the Lee Newton Dining Hall, equipped with full kitchen and all-you-can-eat gourmet buffet. You'll notice we're pet-friendly too.
You only have jelly on offer.
It's cost-effective, Maritha. And I'll let you in on a little secret. The key ingredient is water. So, what do you all think of the Grand Garden Resort?
Penny, Ratu, you know how you searched this place on the internet?
Yeah.
And amazing pictures came up.
Yeah?
I think you'll find that this is what your guests are expecting.
I did think it looked a bit run down in real life.
Why didn't you say something, Ratu?
I didn't want to break your heart, brother.
Well, I can see it too. I just didn't want to say anything either.
You should have said something.
You should have said something.
No point in panicking. When is the official opening?
3 days' time.
And how many bookings do you have?
30.
30? Should we panic now?
Settle down. We'll help you, boys, won't we? We can all get to work, eh? What do you want us to do?
Okay. Sefa, you paint the beach villas. Jono and Tukana, you guys can tidy up the mini golf area. Test out each course and make mini golf great again.
Okay, will do.
Maritha, Salome, jelly is not a meal fit for our guests. Head to the Lee Newton Dining Hall and cook up a storm.
On it.
Oh, another booking.
Which room?
Okay, Penny, we need to fill up this swimming pool.
Not sure that's a good idea, bro. Have you seen our latest water bill? And that's just from all that jelly we made.
Surely there's somewhere we can get water for free.
Let's do this, bro.
Hole number one. The grass is trimmed and we're ready to try this out. Woohoo! Hole in one! Looks like we have a rat problem, Tux. Solved. Now for hole number two. Easy. Uh-oh. Another hole in one.
We almost emptied the whole Pacific Ocean, Penny. But we got there. Want to do a few laps?
Okay. Or maybe not. Ah! It looks like a unicorn puked everywhere.
What do you mean?
Green? Pink? What were you thinking?
You guys know I'm colorblind. Why else would I wear this blue shirt all the time?
Ratu, what have we done? Whatever made us think we'd be capable of running a resort? We have 2 days left and this place looks worse than ever. Not again. Another booking.
Lunch is ready. Why don't you all come into the dining hall? We made plenty of food.
Our food! Where did they all come from?
Would you believe me if I said a T-Rex?
It's hopeless. The grand opening is off. In fact, the Grand Garden Resort may never open again.
Opening or not, I'm starving. Who's coming with me to the Plaza Food Court? I could really go for a slice of green velvet cake.
Word got out about the hotel. Now everybody's cancelling their bookings.
I know, Tux. It's been a hard day. But at least their deposits are non-refundable.
Oh, your hat? Did you leave it behind? I'm sure Uncle Ratu and Uncle Penny will let you go back and get it.
Hopefully none of those rats have found your hat, Tux.
Penny, what's happened?
This is, impossible.
Ah, you're back.
Who are you?
Lee Newton's the name.
That name sounds familiar.
And I believe you're missing this little Tukana. So, Penny, Ratu, I've heard you're the new proud owners of my resort.
Your resort?
I built it back in the day. And when I heard it was reopening, I knew it would need some work.
You did all this yourself?
Even the T-Rex?
When you've built a place, It never takes long to put it back the way it was meant to be. Though I must say, I liked some of your additions.
This must have cost a fortune.
All taken care of, my boys. Consider it a gift.
But everybody's cancelled their reservations.
What? The buffet is full, the linen is crisp, the pool is warm. They don't know what they're missing out on. I know. Invite everyone you know who needs a holiday and let them come for free. The bill is on me.